provides us. It's not the moon that defines us. I can barely swim, and the current's coming in, and the current's coming in again. Stand up when you hear your name, 'cause I think that we're the same. We've got the same old hands, we've made the same old plans. Bail out to the yellow raft, it's got a hold but we can last. We'll watch until it fades away.
So grateful for you, and we wouldn't be here without you. So we want to invite you all to come to dinner with us now.
Oh yes. Sorry.
We just wanted to say, you know, we hope you enjoyed the album, and we look forward to taking a minute to come around and meet all of you guys. But let's head over and get some dinner.
Yes.
Steal my brother's microphone. He had like this prized microphone. It was actually Max. And I would get, you remember, you really got mad at me a few times for using it. Then he gave up because it was like, all right, whatever, he's going to use it. And one day he's going to make me lots of money.
Yeah, I was really supportive as soon as there was a commission involved.
Yeah. Anyway, so then I started to kind of like sing my thoughts. And I'd never done that before. And to be honest with you, I was actually really shy about my voice because a lot of my brothers had told me I had like this Cookie Monster voice, because I did. It was really gruff and like very like gravelly, and but it was an outlet for me. It was something that I could turn to, that I felt like I could express myself finally. Even if I didn't show anybody this song, I could say the things that I wanted to say, whether it was just feeling lonely or like, you know, the feelings that you have sometimes in school. And so that's when music started for me. And then there was no other art. It was just music was everything. It was like the outlet for everything for me. It's
time to take it on satellite radio, the bridge. I like just like, you know what I'm talking about?
I know exactly what you're talking about.
Cat Stevens, Jim Croce, Harry Nilsson, Paul Simon. I love classic rock. I love the Beatles, Rolling Stones, Iron Butterfly, Boston. That's what I grew up listening to. I'd go into my dad's room and he had a vinyl collection, and I'd just go in there and jam out like I was playing the guitar solo to a Boston song. That's how I was introduced to music, so yeah, that's me.
Yeah. I was raised on a lot of my dad's music, so a lot of singer-songwriters, Paul Simon, Billy Joel, Harry Nilsson, Cat Stevens, and then also like what my brothers were listening to. So then that kind of reached into Nirvana. I remember Mac, you had Nirvana. That's how I came across Nirvana. You had their album. I'm trying to remember what one it was. It was the one with the naked kid on the front swimming in the water. So that's kind of where I came across like 90s music. And then I started listening to a lot of 90s alternative, and then some hip hop for a while. I really got into a hip hop phase where I loved Biggie and Tupac and Outkast and stuff like that.
I kind of started playing music with classical with my dad. So I was listening to, you know, like Bach and Beethoven and Mozart, and then like weirder stuff like Sessions and Bartok. And then my older brother was listening to Smashing Pumpkins and Nirvana and Foo Fighters, so I got really into that. And then I kind of discovered John Coltrane and like Chris Beat and Jim Black and Bill Frisell and weird musicians. And then I got super into like prog rock, like Yes and Gentle Giant and King Crimson. And then I kind of realized I just liked all music. And it wasn't really a genre thing. I just liked music that I liked. So.
Yeah, I like songs that really have, you know, a deep story to them. Songs that have a location and like this setting, this, like, you see it all happening. Like Warren Zevon and Tom Waits and John Hyatt, Patsy Cline, Bonnie Raitt, Joni Mitchell, The Beatles, I mean, oh, George Jones, of course, George Jones, Willie Nelson. Anything that Louis really Armstrong, allows you to. Oh, yeah, and Louis Armstrong. My favorite song of all time, absolutely, A Kiss to the Dream On by Louis Armstrong. You cannot listen to that song and feel like there's anything wrong.
Stuck with me. And it says, all the things that I could be, I think I learned in therapy. And I feel like this last couple of years, I really had to start my life over in a lot of ways and kind of wipe the slate clean and figure out who I am, really who I am. And I think that's difficult sometimes because I'm sure all of you grow up and, you know, you grow up and your family is who your family is, and your friends are who your friends are. And the pressures of school tell you that you're this, or you're this, so they'll put you in a category, or you're the jock, or you're the geek, or you're the whatever, you know, the world wants to tell you. But then you take that all away, and you are who you are. And they're behind even the thoughts in your head that you think every day is your being, who you are as an individual, your soul, or whatever that is. So the song's about, you know, at the end of the day, you'll be who you are. You know, it comes back to you. All those things, you know, that you had lost will come back to you. And so I think it's really important, at least for me, to be able to push all those things out of my head and to the pressures. And it's just so much talking in the world. Like, there's so much, you get on the internet, it's just like hate, like so much hate. And it's just like such an ugly thing to me. I feel like it's just really important to kind of just shut all that out and just be yourself and be fine with that, whatever that is, whatever it is, you know what I mean? And that's, that's kind of what that song's about.